A 67-year-old man collapsing and dying in his bathroom wouldn't normally become an international story, and police wouldn't usually lock down his home and search for radioactive contamination. But this dead man was Boris Berezovsky. Once one of Russia's richest men, he has spent the last 12 years living in exile as one of the loudest critics of Russian President Vladimir Putin. The police say they brought in radiation specialists after a paramedic's personal contamination device went off. But they also had other reasons to be cautious. In 2006, Alexander Litvinenko, a friend of Berezovsky's, a former Russian spy, and another vocal Putin critic, died slowly and horribly in London. Scotland Yard determined he'd been murdered in a plot that could have come from the most creative spy fiction. The radioactive element polonium-210 was slipped into his tea during a meeting with another KGB spy. Litvinenko dictated a deathbed statement to the person he thought was ultimately responsible.
You have shown yourself to be as barbaric and ruthless as your most hostile critics have claimed.
In Russia, people have learned there is considerable risk in publicly opposing the government, and money is no protection. Mikhail Khodorkovsky was Russia's wealthiest man. After he began personally funding pro-democracy groups, he was accused of tax fraud and embezzlement. He was convicted, and he's been in prison for almost 10 years. His oil empire was broken up and swallowed by the state. 2012 brought a new crackdown on dissent. Throughout the year, tens of thousands of protesters regularly marched through Moscow in an unprecedented challenge to Putin's rule. Many of that movement's leaders are now being targeted by various criminal investigations. And there were the women of Pussy Riot. They sang a punk prayer calling for Putin to go in Moscow's main cathedral. The performance lasted 30 seconds. Two of them are serving two-year sentences in remote prison camps. The government here insists its courts are fair and just, and the Russian government has always strongly denied having any involvement in the radiation poisoning of Alexander Litvinenko. But there is a lesson, trend, or perhaps coincidence, linking all of these examples and many others too. Bad things can happen to those who openly oppose Russia's leadership. Phil Black, CNN, Moscow.